Hi and welcome everybody. Welcome to one funky episode. This is a response to James Griffith, who started the thread "Show us funk, soul or disco albums from 1970 to 1980. Well, let's skip the disco part and move to the side the soul part and just concentrate on funk records. So the first funk record is by Kool & The Gang, the debut in 1970. Crazy funky album. And for some reason, you may not recognize the cover, this is the Dutch version, released on Blue Elephant Records. And we like Naked Women and Bunnies. And I think all the albums I will show are from the US. This is really where it all started. From 1971, I picked this album. Because it was not easy to choose, especially in the early 70s, so many funk albums. Can you already recognize the more slow, sleazy funk? By Sly and the Family Stone, there's a riot going on. Also a classic album. And I think in part because there were so many bands making and starting funk music that it was for the bands themselves hard to stay in the spotlight or get in the spotlight. So this band moved to Europe. Lafayette, Afro rock band with Sol Makassar. Sol Makassar, such a big influence in funk music, it's amazing. Especially music before 72 and after 72, almost always you can feel the influence of Manu Dibangra with his Sol Makassar. Because as we're moving to 1973, you can hear the funk music on this album is actually very much inspired by funk music started in the late 60s. And that is because this is the godfather of funk. And you only need one scream to know who it is. He was the godfather of song. He is the godfather of song funk. And he will stay forever the godfather of funk. He created something amazing. So easy to find the one on this one. And the interplay with Buddy Bird on this one is just, it's crazy. Now we're moving to 1974. And funk was already changing a little bit. The Meters. What is it called? Bio funk? No, Fire on the Bio. Bayou. The feel of this funk is different, and I think that's the reason they called it Bayou funk, the whole genre. I'm no expert, so I don't know how to recognize it. But the feel is different on the guitar. But still there's organ and everything is there. So. Also classic album this one. But it's fun to see how the funk in the different regions was picked up and made in a different way. Because I now think we're moving more to the south, to New Orleans. And it also seems the groups went bigger and bigger and more people were joining in. And this is the album by the Wild Magnolias. And I think it's the Wild Magnolias and what was the official line says? I thought it was something like Wild Magnolias and the I can't remember. Yeah, The Wild Magnolias with the New Orleans Project. That's the complete title. And this is already one of the first albums with a vocoder, I think. And the next album, because funk was so horn powered in some regions, and this is also true for the next one. This is Muscle Shoals horn. Born to get down. And we're already now in 1976 and the funk was still hot. But disco was coming. So for me, this is where it started to get a little bit more. Well, I had to select my albums carefully because I did not want to have the disco influence in the music. So I got this one out. Let me find the right song I want to find. Yeah. So, can you recognize it? It's Johnny Guitar Watson, and this is the song side B, Lover Jones. It's such a great song. This album is really underrated because the first track on it is, of course, A Real Mother for You, but there's so many great songs in this album.
I didn't get the slightest one.
And what is amazing that he has written all the material on the album, but he also plays all the instruments. Well, except for the drums and the horns. But the guitars, the keyboards, the Rhodes, the bass, he does everything.
You sure know how to be a woman. Yeah. And you know how to let a man be a man. I just like to say.
And now comes a band which I think many expected to be in the early part, but I moved it back to the later 70s. The funk really started to get party music. And this is Funkadelic, One Nation Under a Groove. Also, classic, classic material. But it was harder and harder to find real funk records in the late 70s. And a change was coming, of course. And this change, you cannot yet feel it on this one because we are moving to 1979, but there was already one guy who was making the funk of the future. But here we have still horn powered funk, nice bass line. That's pleasure. And this was the biggest song on it, Glide, but also the other songs on the album are really funky. And it still has that funk groove. This is no soul, this is no disco. But this is, I think, one of the last real funk albums in the 70s style, because the 80s were coming and there was one genius who led the way to give us the new taste of what was coming, and he saw a new direction for funk, because disco was already killed and punk was ready to kill funk, but this one, he said no, funk has a new future. Yeah, it's also like James Brown, immediately recognizable. There's just a slight edge on it that makes it different. And we're talking, of course, about Prince. 1980, we come to the end of the series from 1970 to 1980. 11 funk albums. I hope you enjoyed it. See you next time.